He is stern, decisive. He seems to be determined to make it happen, and it did happen.
He walked for us, and so I could walk all this way for him.
Those were some of the thoughts buzzing through the air in our nation's capital recently with the long-awaited official dedication of the Martin Luther King Jr. National Memorial. The dedication was originally to take place in August, but Hurricane Irene forced its postponement until October. August 28th marked the 48th anniversary of King's March on Washington, where he delivered his famed I Have a Dream speech. Many of those who were coming to Washington, D.C. to see the memorial up close and to pay their respects were born well after King's assassination. But for others, the struggle for civil rights was more than just a chapter in a history book.
I understand the pain because I went through a lot of it. When my son was 5 years old, down on Marietta Street, he had to go to the bathroom, and they would not allow him to go to the bathroom in this store. Who would deny a child to use the bathroom? And it just, the burning in me that made me want to fight for the cause.
Out of the mountain of despair, a stone of hope. It was that line from King's famous 1963 speech delivered in front of the Lincoln Memorial that inspired the design for the monument. The Stone of Hope, which features the relief of Dr. Martin Luther King Jr., is 30 feet high and creates the illusion of having been pushed out of the middle of the mountain of despair. The mountain of despair is the threshold that visitors walk through when they first enter the memorial site. Dr. King looks out across the tidal basin towards the Jefferson Memorial.
The monument itself is absolutely great. I mean, it's a chisel out of the mountain. It's like they took a piece out of the mountain and they moved it forward. And he is looking straight at the other great leaders of this nation.
The MLK Memorial helps to create a line of leadership between two of the country's most indelible presidents. Thomas Jefferson, who helped found the United States and author of the Declaration of Independence, and Abraham Lincoln, who held the country together when civil war threatened to tear us apart.
I remember when he once said, "Free at last, free at last," and remembering when he said he wanted to see little boys and little white boys and little black girls sit on the same bus together. Each time I see us as a nation that are doing things together, it brings back the things that he taught and preached and wanted to happen during those during the time that he was here.
He was a man that really made up his mind what needs to happen and made it happen.
For Atlanta Now, I'm Troy Danicus.